you're familiar with Carbon Arc. So I'm running 6s and 7s in here. And so I can't trim the curves, but that's a bright light. That's a very bright light. See the carbon's burning in this window here. And you don't find many of Carbon Arc ones left anymore because the Strong company that built those put out a rebate where they'll buy the Carbon Arc lamp part of it and replace it with a xenon portion. And so it was cheap for people to switch over to xenon. But then again, you don't find the arc anymore. People ask, Jake, can you show us a movie? So I like to have things that other people have seen. During the winter, down at the Oregon, it's absolutely freezing cold and I can't go play. So I have this little organ up here, and it's a heated room. And so I can play it and still have something to play. One of my hobbies is telephone systems. And you might want to take a look at this. I built this. Every telephone in the building goes through this. It's a complete exchange. Wow. And it works perfectly fine. Thank you.
pretty amazing.
There are 70 fonts in the building. They all go through that.
Did you say 70?
Well, fonts are my hobby.
Yes.
So, it ties the Oregon telephones and the British Action Booth telephones. So, all my hobbies are tied together through this system. Here's a fairly modern Moviola. And behind that is a Carbon Arc Magic Lantern projector from 1913. Someday I'll restore it or give it to somebody that will. This movie was shot on Catalina Island.
Just run. How am I going to land anyone? This camera's right in front of my nose.
Don't reach me. I'm not going to.
That's it, everybody! Out to sea!
Collected everything that's in this room. Restored it, installed it, operated it. The most modern film handling equipment on the face of the earth. These are the original 1932 sound heads, which of course originally used to strip the sound off using photocells.
Mm-hmm.
And I have a machine shop at home. I switched them over so they use solar cells. Much better frequency response. And the old RCA photo phone still has the look and the feel, but I've built all state-of-the-art sound, solid-state amplification for it. Our Dolby sound here is fantastic. Best sound in the county, I have to say. Now there's a little bigger carbon than the follow spots. And these carbons are held by water-cooled jaws because the carbons would melt them if they weren't water-cooled. And the carbons rotate and they automatically feed. For the technology of the day, these were really quite advanced lamps. Projectionist comes in, sturdy shift, he puts his TV dinner in there, warms it up while the movie's going. Hello? Hi, baby. There's a film fella down that wants to see the theater. What can I help you with? What can I help you with? Oh, I feel horrible. What's wrong? I can't walk. Hello?
To eat restaurant?
I did. I ate that can of chili like I told you.
And it stayed down?
It stayed down, and about 10 hours later, and I'm sure everybody will want to know this, it came out just fine. Okay.
Bye.
Bye. Okay, now it'll go just fine. Is that my wrist making that noise? This is very frustrating. Let me get my glasses. I only need these when I want to see. See the tips of the curves. There we go. When it finally builds up a plasma ball between them, now we're putting out some carbon arc light. Trailer for the Green Mile. Oh, don't ever get old.